Capricorn, welcome to your general reading for the rest of October 2024 with me, Adrian Nelson, your psychic tarot reader. So, beautiful, beautiful Capricorn. Let's see what we've got. Dealing with a Capricorn, have you got Capricorn in your chart, whatever brought you to this reading, beautiful soul, there is a message here for you. So open yourself to receive, okay? I'm going to draw your general reading, going to clarify, I'm going to end off with three cards from the universe. One for money, one for health, one for love. So definitely stick around till the end for that, okay? Good news is there's no unnecessary ads in the middle of this reading, so you can just watch the thing unhindered from beginning to end. Isn't that a pleasure, right? Okay, Capricorn, let's see what we've got. If it's your first time here, I'd like to welcome you. Thank you for your time. Thank you for your presence. Thank you for your energy contribution. If you're coming back, welcome back. Thank you so much for your support. I really appreciate it. If you haven't yet done so, I would appreciate you considering subscribing to the channel. So, Five of Swords. Five of Swords is always a little bit of a catch-22 sort of situation, you know? Because you kind of know what you should do and you're kind of not sure if you should do it. And you, it's a very trippy sort of space to be in, okay? So if you are going through a trippy space at the moment, Capricorn, and remember, this could even be you witnessing someone else going through a trippy space, you know, or witnessing the world going through a trippy space and becoming very overwhelmed by it. There is a choice that you need to make. And the choice that you need to make, my beautiful Capricorn, is that you can observe the world, you know, you can help and support the world as much as you need to. But, and this is very important for you, Capricorn, it is not your job to save the world, okay? I want you to remember, now this is a little bit of a challenging concept to, you know, initially wrap our minds around sometimes, but your world is it's a portrayal, it's a mirror reflection of your inner world, of who you are. I'm putting that crystal over there for healing. That's my Lemurian course for distance healing, okay? Or if you come and have a session with me, it's always with me, okay? But this is a space where you need to make a choice, my beautiful Capricorn. And it seems like your energy that I'm picking up here, even with the star energy coming out here, you've got a lot of cards that is in a lot of positions for like the other zodiac placements. So if you are having a strong influence of a different zodiac energy in your life currently happening, you know, be this a partner or a friend or a colleague or a family member, a neighbor, whatever the case may be, you know, fellow practitioner, whatever the case may be, maybe go and take a look at that person's reading, because I kind of feel like you are taking on other people's energy, and the time has come for you to stop taking on other people's energy. Because when you take on another person's energy, Capricorn, what you are also doing is you're understanding it to be your own. And because you understand it to be your own, what you then understand subsequently is that the onus falls upon you to clear and to resolve this, where nothing could be further from the truth. Okay? You want to really hear me on that now, okay? What you are believing at the moment, everything that you are believing at the moment to be real could possibly be nothing further from the truth. Okay? So let's take a look here, because this is quite interesting. What an interesting way to start off a reading. If you are open to learning cards, because it always helps you to get direction, how to read them, my beautiful Capricorn, go ahead and take a look at the links for my courses down below in the description. They're very good, okay? Let's look at this Five of Swords energy. What is going on here? Okay, so something is falling apart so that something better can move in and its place. Okay? Something's falling apart so that something better can move into its place, can take its place. So if you are seeing any sort of controversies happening inside of you and around you, know that this is like a big purge that is happening, Capricorn. Okay? And remember that, again, as I say this again, your outer world is a reflection of your inner world. Okay? Now, that doesn't mean that we look at our outer world and we go like, oh, crap. You know, what a horrible world am I creating for myself? I must be so dark inside. I've got so much work to do. I must be so negative. Nope. You slow your roll right down there. Okay? What you want to do here, Capricorn, is you want to see the truth of what's going on without any judgment, no bias. Remember, judgment is also bias, because judgment is that calling that something or someone is wrong there, you know? So you are in the space where I want to say to you, don't worry if things seem like they are falling into place, because, you know, don't worry if it seems like, sorry, let me just rephrase that. Don't worry if it seems like things are falling apart here for you, my beautiful, beautiful Capricorn, because something magical is taking its place. There is abundance. There's a breakthrough here. We're going to draw a card for money, but there is a breakthrough here. There is an opportunity here. There's an inheritance. There's money. Something is rolling away, and it's rolling away super smooth. Okay? Feel your feelings. Some of you are feeling some feelings of lack, some feelings of limitation, some feelings of being throttled, not good enough, not strong enough, not accepting enough, not worthy enough, all of those things. You know, we are humans, we feel these things. And with the ascension that's currently taking place, my beautiful Capricorn, it's normal for you to feel those things, because a lot of it is very generational things. Like one of my Theta healing clients, for example, you know, had the experience that she really felt that some really terrible things have happened to her in this life, which she knows for a fact that hasn't. And she couldn't understand, why am I having these horrific, almost like bodily, you know, reactions, like this happened to me, you know, like I have been, you know, sort of like, you know, victimized this way, you know, that this has happened to me, almost like a pedophile type of thing. Why do I feel this if I know that it happened? And this is what's happening for many of you as well, Capricorn. It is the generational knowledge that is beginning to unlock within you. And it is unlocking because you're just becoming aware of the fact that you are so much more than just you, than just your life. You know, you're connecting with very broad energies at the moment. And so this is a time to be very gentle and very kind with yourself, and not to go and take unnecessary steps to try and put out any fires, okay? So this is the thing, like it's not a time for you to put out any fires. Let everything burn down to the ground, okay? But in so saying, what I mean is, when I say let it burn down to the ground, I don't mean like, you know, do nothing when you know you need to take action. What I mean is that stop trying to save something or someone or a connection or a relationship or a person that isn't all that interested in saving, you know, or having something saved with you. Let it go. Allow yourself to peacefully let it go. And if you can't feel the peace, allow yourself to feel as much peace as you possibly can, and then make a point and a commitment of seeking the guidance and the support and the direction that you need to help you to progress to that next level. That Eight of Cups is saying, what decision do you want to make? You know, commit to going to that next level. What does it take to get you there? What are the emotions that you are dealing with? What are the conflicts that you are dealing with? What are the challenges that you are dealing with? Okay? If you are open to Source supporting you through all of these things, my beautiful Capricorn, go ahead and place your hand on your heart. Take a nice deep breath, say yes to it, write down in the comments, I am ready. Because ready you are. So here's the thing. A lot of times when we are, you know, so like your subconscious mind already knows that you are ready, and it hasn't sort of fully filtered through to your conscious mind yet, because you might still be dealing with some other things, you know, that does feel a little bit outdated. Life is to find a way to remind you. And sometimes that means it brings up a challenge, because you're going to listen to the challenge. You know, you're going to pay attention to it, and it's making you aware, my beautiful Capricorn, that you are ready to progress to the next level like nobody's business. You are ready for it. You are ready to shine. You are ready to glow. This one, you are just ready. But you don't feel ready. You see, that is the problem there with the Five of Pentacles. So, this, you know, this is one of those classic cases I'm picking up here, Capricorn, where we want to first see that it's going to work. You're like, you know, I need some sign of guarantee. You need to give me something. You can't ask me to go on blind faith here. And that is exactly what Spirit is asking you to do right now. Because as you go on blind faith, you open yourself to the idea that there's better and more that's available to you. And that is how you conclude the cycle. It seems like the final lesson for you, the final lesson before abundance, is trust. Okay? that final lesson before that incredible abundance comes through there for you, my beautiful Capricorn, is trust. As you are being challenged by trust. And you also want to be mindful, you know, maybe if it's either you doing it or being in companies that does it, little gossip thing is, because gossip is a way of really sort of like deflecting our own stuff onto other people, because then, you know, you take the limelight off you. Okay? Be careful of those connections here with the Knight of Cups. Be mindful of the company that you keep. Don't keep low-vibing company. Don't watch low-vibing things on television or Netflix or, you know, whatever it is that you are watching. Okay? Keep it high-vibing. Keep it positive. Okay? The Three of Wands. All right? Your ship is in the harbor, it's available, but somehow there is an energy within you, there is a wound that is not fully healed within you, Capricorn, that is trying to sabotage things here for you. And so this is a time for you to really be gentle with yourself, but simultaneously to very firmly and very clearly decide and make that choice and saying, I'm saying yes in this moment to my highest and greatest potential in ways that only serve my highest and best interest. In the truth and perspective of the Creator. And if you're saying yes to it, hand on the heart, nice deep breath, say yes to it. Okay? For money, you got the Ace of Swords. Make a decision. So that is basically everything that we just spoke about now, my beautiful Capricorn. Make a decision. Make a commitment to yourself. And, you know, a wonderful way to also work this is to really spend some time and ask yourself, what does wealth mean to me? Okay? What does wealth mean to me? And think bigger than money. Okay? Because the bigger you think, the better the opportunities come to you, but you want to feel it. So, for example, to me, I have recently moved to the beautiful town called Greyton here in Cape Town, well, close to Cape Town in South Africa, but it's literally a valley in the mountains. And so, for me, wealth is that at night, you know, at 7 o'clock, you know, most of the town is indoors. You know, I maybe see like 2 or 3 people. I can take my dog for a walk. There's a beautiful sense of safety. Nobody's going to be looking for trouble with me or try to rob me or, you know, try to con me into something. People just say hi and they pass by. It's beautiful. It's safe. Early in the morning, I can go for a walk. It's just beautiful. To me, that is wealth. You know, to me, the silence, it is peace. You know, it's beautiful for me. It's beautiful that I can record a reading for you and I don't have to be concerned about lots of heavy traffic passing by and, you know, people in the road shouting and screaming and swearing at each other. To me, that is wealth, that is abundance. So what is it for you? Think of it like that and feel it, and that is how life makes it real for you. Okay, think of money like that. Then we look at health, which is physical health, mental health, emotional health, an overall sense of well-being. And you have got the Star energy, Aquarius energy, so you've got it twice. All right, this is beautiful. We're really going into that age of Aquarius now, you know, where the energy itself is beautifully settled. Allow yourself to be gentle with yourself as you do this introspection. The introspection is very necessary, my beautiful Capricorns. Very necessary. But be patient with yourself, be kind with yourself, be calm with yourself. You know, if you're healing, yes, healing might bring up some wounds and scars, but if it doesn't overall help you to feel peaceful, then maybe you want to do something different. You know, be with someone different, maybe. I once had a client who said to me, Adrian, I have been with this particular practitioner for 8 years now, a more Western sort of practicing practitioner. You know, through the pandemic, we will do things online, and we're not, like, what do you suggest? I said, well, I suggest you move away from that person because it's been 8 years. Now, it doesn't mean that that person didn't help them, but this person needed more. And so you're in a space where you need more. And I feel that, you know, don't be in a space where you maybe hold on to the same thing or the same person because you might feel guilty, because then what happens is we begin to actually subconsciously place obligations upon those people to meet a certain expectation which they may be unwilling or incapable of meeting. But when we can be open to peacefully, I go in my direction, you go in your direction, and you say, Source, Universe, help me. That is when that beautiful solution comes through that is in the highest and best interest of everyone, and may it be so for you. All right. So my beautiful Capricorn, that's what I have. I hope it helps. Remember to like, share, comment, and subscribe. And I look forward to connecting with you on the next video.